Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna make an egg noodle pasta. So let me give you the ingredients. So for our egg noodle pasta, we're gonna make a basic recipe, okay? Just a classic basic recipe, neutral. So 2 cups of flour, and then you can use 1.5 cup of flour, and then 1/2 cup of semolina is gonna be optional, but usually that's how it goes, you know? So that way semolina is thinner than the cornmeal, okay? So it's same size of the flour, but it's gonna be cornmeal. And that's gonna be optional also. But we usually put it on the restaurant, the semolina, just a little bit. So that way it helps our pasta to make a little grainy, more better. But this is gonna be for the house, so you can add it if you want, or you can leave it without. So we're gonna add a little salt to taste. Black pepper, it's gonna be optional. You can add, change any flavor, any ingredient that you want into this recipe. Like I say, this is just a basic egg noodle pasta, but as we're in a pattern, in a fall, I'm gonna change my pasta to orange color. You can always use roasted bell peppers, tomato paste, any seasoning. You can always use paprika to change it, you know, to make the color different. It's gonna be optional. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add 1 package of the sazon with the cilantro and achiote, and this is gonna help me make my pasta orange when I start mixing it with my dough. Right now you cannot see it, but as soon as I add the water, you're gonna see the color changing, okay? So I'm gonna have to come back and show you the next step. We're gonna add the wet ingredients. We're gonna add 1 tablespoon of oil, and then the eggs, the yolks. Then you're just gonna start making your dough. You can add 1 egg at a time, or you can do more, however you wanna do it. You can always use your mixer, your blender, but it's gonna be optional. I'm just doing it like the naan I used to make it before. So then you're just gonna keep mixing it into have a pasta shape, a dough. So I'm gonna come back when this is done and start working our pasta. Okay, so as you can see, it's kinda dry, so I'm gonna add a little water, and you're just gonna judge it, how much water you need. Well, it's gonna be, I would say, about 3 tablespoons, okay? And then come back and show you the next step. You can see our dough is almost done. It's still sticking to the table, but that's why we always have some extra flour on the side. It's a bench flour, so that way you can finish it. And how do you know when your pasta is done? When it doesn't stick to the table anymore. Okay. And then you just pick up your rest of that pasta, whatever is on the table. And you're always gonna need extra flour on the side, because we're gonna do our pasta, when we start rolling it, we're gonna need to add some of the semolina, or 1/2 and 1/2 flour and semolina, so that way we can work our pasta. So we're gonna let it rest and come back and start making our pasta shapes. Alright, so after you have your pasta already resting, I cut it in half. So now we're gonna start making our sheets, okay? This is just a sample on the thickness. This is the number 7 on my pasta machine. It's a hand cranking machine. You can use the electrical one, or you can use your pin roller, and then, you know, make it like that. It's gonna be up to you, however you wanna do it. So that's why we need some flour or semolina on the table, on our bench table. And then we're gonna start making our shape. Make sure, you know, it's thin enough, so that way you don't struggle with the machine. It doesn't rip on you, so make sure you know it's nice and thin. So first we're gonna go on the number 7, which is the thicker part, and it goes all the way to number 2, number 1. And we're gonna go ahead and do our first roll. In the beginning it's gonna be sticky. Okay. So now you're just gonna add, every time you pass it through the machine, you add flour, semolina. Okay. So we're gonna do the same thing. Fold it in half. And this is just the beginning on the pasta. Then you can do only one way. You don't have to fold it anymore. Same thing. Little flour. And roll it. And then we're gonna go through all the numbers. As you can see. Now we're gonna go to all the numbers, we're gonna go down. So now I'm gonna go number 6 and like that. So I'm gonna come back when this is done and show you the final result on the pasta. So after you have your sheets already rolled up like this, thinly, number 2, now they're gonna be ready to make your shapes. So you can use this dough for fettuccine, tagliolini, spaghetti, linguini on the egg noodle pastas, pappardelle, farfalles, raviolis, any shaped raviolis, lasagna sheets. So this is a basic dough technique recipe that you can use for anything. It's a multi-purpose. You can use it and make whatever you want. So what we're gonna do next, now you're gonna remove all the excess of the semolina. We don't want any. So with a brush. And then we're gonna use our cutters. You can use any shape. So any size. You can use the one that they're plain, that they don't have the ribbon. And I got these ones already cut. So we're gonna go with this one. I don't see the number, but I think it's the 8. So then with the stuffing, we're gonna measure our raviolis, mark them, basically pre-cut them, okay? And then we're gonna use our egg wash, so that way it's gonna help us with our dough, so that way sticks together, okay? Since we're gonna have these ones left, and you can save it and make your some scrambled eggs, egg whites, whatever you want to do with that. But I got my feelings here. So what I was saying, you know, we're gonna mark them. So I'm gonna do this way. 4, 6, 8. And then we're just gonna do the pumpkin, butternut squash. And like I said before, you can make any filling that you like. And a little bit goes a long way, so. And also I have my braised beef and red wine. You can use anything, you can make a spinach and garlic, you name it, you know, you can do any stuff and any filling that you like. You can go just simple or you can go fancy. Either or. So now we're gonna just fold it. You can do it however you like, any style. But it's up to you. And then we usually get a shot glass and remove the air of the pasta, okay? So just tie them up just like that.
and that's how you make your round shape raviolis. And then you just cut them. And these ones are done. So, and these, they cook in about 3 to 4 minutes. You have your pasta water already salted, you know, bring it to boil. And then this cook very fast. Only takes about 3 to 4 minutes. Into their floating, and they're done. And then same procedure with the pasta. Save it. You can reuse it again until you don't have anything else. Creamings, you can make different pasta shapes for soups or anything. And then we use some of the bench flour or semolina just to dust them. These ones are done. You can make them, freeze them if you like, and then you take them out as you need it. Okay? So hopefully you guys like this video on how to make the fresh raviolis or fresh pasta. And stay tuned for my recipe for the sauce. I'm gonna make brown butter and sage, and also some prosciutto and red wine cream sauce. So stay tuned for those recipes. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Chef Alex Perez on Facebook, Chef Alex Perez on YouTube. Share my videos, and we'll see you next time. Thank you, enjoy. All right, like I said before, you know, you can make any shape, anything with this dough. So we can make triangle one, then you can change it to this shape. So it's just depending which shape you want to use. Okay, so in the restaurant we make different shapes, different ways to do the raviolis. You can always do this one also, just like that. Okay, then that's one. Then the other one, where you have your surrounded knife. So that one, I don't have my cutter, but that'll be like this. Same thing here. And that's just another different ravioli. Okay, so since we're gonna use this on the fall, I'm gonna make some caramels or candies, a little candy shaped raviolis. So this is what you do. You can do it like that, or just wrap it like that. So like the Italian says, el caramelle. So hopefully you guys like this video, different shapes, and have fun with your kids. Stay tuned for the sauces. I'm gonna make a different sauce for each ravioli. I'm gonna make a creamy sauce, and then just the brown butter and sage. So that way you can stay tuned for the recipes. Thank you.